In this movie, we're going to have a look at Trash 2 by iZotope and look at its wave-shaping distortion capabilities. So I have Trash 2 here inserted on a track. I've got just a drum beat happening right now. And it's a good sound source for trying to work through how this plugin makes distortion and explore some of its features. It's a wave-shaping distortion plugin. What's nice about this one is that this is the actual wave shaper, and we can actually manipulate it and make our own wave shaping curves. So we have a lot of control over the actual kind of distortion we make. So I have a number of modules here in Trash, and they're all shut off right now except for the actual Trash module, which is where I have the wave shaper. There are two different wave shapers here. I can have two stages of distortion, and stage two is turned off right now. So I'm just working with this wave shaper. There's also a filter, just a high and low filter after the distortion. And again, for now, I have this turned off. So pretty simple setup here. This is the wave shaper, and it's currently a symmetrical distortion setup. And what I have here is the ability to change the wave shaper in this quadrant. And then whatever changes I make to this quadrant, this is the positive amplitudes, input versus output. I'll see the same change applied to this quadrant, negative amplitudes, input versus output. So here I just have simply a unity gain function here. It's just my drum beat. But then I can apply a little bit of a wave shaping distortion here. So now these are the input versus the output values here, and they've been changed a little bit. Some of these lower amplitudes are now a little higher at the output. Little bit of very gentle distortion. Mostly just a little louder. And then I can take the peak amplitude and take it down a little bit. And again, notice that whatever I do to this quadrant, I get the mirror image in this quadrant here. It's symmetrical distortion. I can add a point here, just double clicking. If I want to, I can option click to remove it, or click here to remove it. So I'm going to add another point, and I'm going to change the wave shaping a little bit. Here's the original. Especially the kick drum, I can hear there's almost like a gated kind of effect. Now I'm going to go the other way, but this is where you have to be careful because I'm taking these low level amplitudes at the input and I'm making them much louder at the output. So this is where we're going to get some crunchiness. This is where you want to be a little careful as you explore. Now if I wish I could see this curve a little more closely, I can here in the zoom. I can just click on this quadrant and I'll see just this quadrant zoomed up close, and I know this quadrant is going to give me the same curve because it's a symmetrical distortion setup. I'm going to delete this here, just option click. Now this connection between these two points is determined by this setting here. I currently have tension, which is how I can change the actual shape of this curve. I can have it do other things as well. For example, I can have just a linear connection. So there's no more of an exponential kind of curve, but simply a line to this point and then a line to this point. And if I add more points, I have linear connections. I'm going to clear all of this just by clicking on clear all. I can also have the connection be made with a bunch of squared functions here. Now I have to be very careful. This is going to be very loud. So I'm going to come over here, turn the gain down. That's pretty radical. And you can see in both quadrants what's happening. From here, I can turn down the maximum peaks here of all of these squares. And if I get that little point in the middle here and pull up or down, I can actually change the density of the squares. And so now I have almost like a gated kind of effect here. Because so many of these amplitudes at the input map to zero at the output. Although I could move them off zero line, and now they're all going to get mapped to something other than zero. Like that. I'm going to clear it again. Instead of squares, I can have triangles. I can have sine functions. Or kind of a stair-stepping here. And this is going to be almost like quantization here. And go ahead and decrease the number of steps. Increase it. And move them off of zero, which gets pretty loud, or even exchange positive values for negative values at the output. So a polarity change for just the lower amplitudes, creating quite a lot of distortion. And of course, with the mix control, I can blend it with the original. So this is the basic idea with a wave shaper. And here, now I get to actually play with and control the shape of the wave shaping distortion.